What are the trademarks of revival? A gathering together of believers.
What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what's never entered into the heart of man, that becomes normal for me. The same way trouble used to track you down without you trying, the almighty blessing of God will track you down. Surely goodness and mercy will follow you every day of your life. Get ready for a week like no other week. What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard.
A burden for the lost and a hunger for the word.
The only hope for America is men and women full of the fire, full of the anointing of God. There's no other hope. Without preachers, without men and women whose mouth has been set on fire, that would go and proclaim the gospel every day of the week and shout it from the mountaintops. I believe sitting in this room tonight are men and women that are going to wreck what the enemy's doing. The devil's not going to have America. He's not going to have this land. He's not going to have this land.
The fulfillment of prophecy.
Nobody knew Pastor Shuttlesworth before. He was a little one, but that prophecy was upon his head. A little one shall become a thousand. It is happening practically. And a small one shall become a strong nation. My God. Wata malosa abandola manda. A small one shall become a nation. Do you receive this grace upon your life? A little one shall become a thousand. Receive a thousand members, a thousand members, a thousand members. A little one shall become a thousand.
An outpouring of generosity towards God.
I pray thee, if I have found favor in thine eyes, tarry. For I have learned by experience that the Lord had blessed me for thy sake. Anointing increase. By association there. I'm blessed because of you. See, it's called increase by association. You have that on you as a Christian. His nature, God, is to bless. His prerogative is to bless. His glory is to bless. His delight is to bless. His blessing is without ceasing. Well, Lord, Jesus, touch him. Jesus, touch these people, Lord. Bless them, Lord, and honor them today. Come on, people, keep praying with me. He said, tell him he can live as long as he want to live. Yeah. He can do whatever he want to do in Jesus' mighty name.
The manifest presence of God with signs and wonders.
God says, I want to show off. I want to show the world and the devil my products. I want to show the world what I can do, who I can produce. I want to show off with the church. I want to show off with that woman. I want to show off. I want to show off Ayabaga Dagalaya Tasatata. It's an exhibition. It's an advertisement. Oh, my Sheke Peke Tekala. It's a superior supernatural marketing. I want to show somebody off. God is about to show off with the church. It's about to show off with the gospel. It's about to show off. It's about to showcase.
The gifts of the Holy Spirit at work.
I don't know if the doctor told you, you had a rupture in your eye. Isn't that right? Said it would never be better. Thou foul spirit of blindness, come.
Help!
In Jesus' name, open. Just get a little weary in that limb. Isn't that right? You have the beginning of sugar diabetes in your body. I take it out, the spirit of infirmity, because you know what's on the other side of your prayer. You know what's on the other side of your miracle. Oh, hallelujah. I got a shout when no one else is shouting. I got a song when no one else is singing. That's what God wants us to do. Thank God for the spirit of Almighty God.
I am born of God. I am in Christ. I go from victory to victory. I go from glory to glory. And I go from strength to strength. I don't go from sickness to sickness. Oh, how does it feel to fail? How does it feel to lose? And I said, you know what? Why don't I ask the biggest loser that ever lived? So I said, where can I find the biggest loser? And I remember what the word of the Lord said. For the biggest loser brought under my feet. I said, hey, loser, how does it feel to lose? And just as he was about to speak, I put my foot down and I said, hey, you lost the opportunity to speak again. You are not allowed to speak. Somebody shout out, hallelujah.
A surge of people being called into the full-time ministry. Because the Bible says, go into all the earth, into all the world, and preach the gospel to everyone, everywhere. I've got a part to play. I need to work. If you want to take over the land, you have a role to play.
May the Abrahamic grace to command your household to keep the way of the Lord come upon you today. That God won't be something on your list of things to do. You will be a God first, church first, Bible first, first century book of Acts Christian, and your children and your children's children. Receive that today. I see America turning around by the hand of God.
These are the trademarks of revival.
Well, welcome to Los Angeles, California. I'm Jonathan Shuttlesworth. So pleased that you would take time out of your day to join a wretch like me who once was lost, but now I'm found. It's blind and now I can see. Glad that you're here. Had a great night last night in Los Angeles. Recap available, question mark? Take a look at what the Lord did last night, and everybody that was there, I really love you. Thanks for coming. If you haven't heard, if you came Sunday and were discouraged from coming back because you didn't want to pay $25 a night for parking, which I don't blame you, we are comping parking the rest of the week. So crowd back up. Thanks for helping me get the announcement out, and here's what the Lord did last night.
God gave us a weapon called faith. It's a mighty weapon. It parts the sea. It dries the ground out. It's what fed 1.3 million Israelites every day in the desert. It's what brought quail up from the water. I want to tell you right now, if you're looking for a nice message to encourage you while you go out and get your head slapped around by the devil, you're in the wrong meeting. We're not here to endure life's problems. We're here to dominate the powers of darkness by the power of the resurrected Christ who lives on the inside of you. I prophesy tonight to this group of people that fought traffic on Tuesday night to come and hear the word. Every immovable force in your life is going to be driven out tonight by the anointing in Jesus' mighty name. If you receive that with me, do what you're already doing. Take 15 good seconds. Clap your hands, all ye people. I feel victory in this room.
There it was. April 14th and 19th, so we got tonight, Thursday and Friday, if you'd like to join us at the Sheraton Gateway, Los Angeles International Airport, 6101 West Century Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90045, 7 o'clock every night. You can register at revivaltoday.com events. We have nice free gifts for you as a way of saying thank you for registering and taking time to let us know that you're going to be there. Thanks, Darlene. Is that you that was there with your son last night? Your son, if I'm thinking of the right person, your son's a trip. I really like him. Lisa, good to see you. I had the best cheesesteak of my life last night and the best milkshake of my life. I made one of the worst decisions I've ever made in my life to go eat at 1:30 in the morning and have about 3,200 calories. But I'm telling you, okay, let's just get into things no one cares about. If you ever see a... No? If you ever get into a Philly cheesesteak, if you ever see Philly cheesesteak on a menu, they use that term a lot, but it's a lie. It's like it's the culinary equivalent of a Joe Biden speech. Because what makes Kalani, there is no parking charge because it is expensive. 25, if people are going to come all week, that's $150. So I thought that was a little excessive. Getting back to important things that nobody tuned in today to watch. If you see Philly cheesesteak, they lie about it. Because what makes a Philly cheesesteak a Philly cheesesteak is that most places use, Jasmine said, deliverance, spelled D-L-I-V-R-E-N-C-E. Spelled it that way twice. Deliverance, hallelujah. D-L-I-V-R-E-N-C-E. Well, I'll join in faith with you. Father, I bind that spirit that keeps her from being able to spell simple words in the English language. Father, grant unto her her right mind to sound out and spell words. In Jesus' mighty name. We loose that to you in your house today. Anyway, back to cheesesteaks. Most places use sirloin or something like that, steakums. What makes the Philadelphia one so good is they use shaved ribeye, high-grade shaved ribeye. Then with onion, you can get it without onion, but you should get it with onion. And then they use Cheese Whiz, which sounds gross, but the origin of it, again, the fact that I've taken time to study this stuff and not study like options trading, even though I do options trading and have the portfolio to prove that I've never studied options trading. If you could make a fortune finding out which options I bought and then just doing the exact opposite of what I'm doing, everybody would be a millionaire. I should start a service, inverse Jonathan Shuttlesworth. So anyway, because Orthodox Jewish people will not eat meat cooked in their mother's milk that's in the Old Testament, so they won't have cheese with their meat. So they use Cheese Whiz because there's no actual cheese in Cheese Whiz. That's why it's spelled C-H-E-E-Z. They made it like that, but what it does is, the first time I heard that, I thought, that's gross. I'm going to have provolone on it, but it makes it too dry. So they didn't do it with Cheese Whiz, but they use real shaved ribeyes. This place is called Fat Sal's. And I had them, they have a Fat Sal's sauce, so I had them put that on it, and it made it Cheese Whiz-like, but better. I think it's their bread was amazing. It's the best. It's right on Venice Beach. It's the best cheesesteak I've ever had and the best milkshake I've ever had in my life. The food out here, I'm telling you, I've had a great week. I feel the best I've ever felt. Weather's great. My body feels great. California is an awesome place. You won me over. But today, we're not talking about cheesesteaks. We're talking about more important things. The update on the Moldovan sword swallower. You don't need a breakthrough. You need a job. And why Christians are unable to do simple math. This is coming to you live from Los Angeles, California. So we'll take a look quickly. I don't have a financial overflow book, huh? Okay. I don't have. We'll take a look at what's going on in the world. And then I really think you'll enjoy today. And I think it'll help a lot of people. Isaac said, I've never seen a Philly with Cheese Whiz. Then you've never seen, where do you live, Isaac? You don't live in Philadelphia. That's not like a way to make it. That's how it's made. Good to see you, Mitch, in Ireland. Good to see you, Philip, on the app. My cousin Phil in California, I think I'm going to see you at the end of the week. Lisa. Lisa says, they do one in Philly with pork, provolone, and broccoli rub. Yes, they do. And in my opinion, the best one is at Reading Terminal Market at Denick's. Philadelphia, New Jersey is great food-wise, but California might be the best in the country. I've never seen a place that takes food as seriously as this. Las Vegas might be the best because they don't have anything of their own, but they have like the best of the whole world there. I don't want to say they don't have anything of their own. But again, we're not here to talk about food, even though I don't mind doing it. Then somebody wrote, apostles, prophets, teachers, pastors, etc. Okay. Like just on your own wavelength there. Thanks, Jake. I don't, you know, I am a Christian. I am a C. I am a CH. I am a CHRSTIN. But I don't understand a lot of Christians. I don't. I don't want to mock people. I do a little, but not like, I could play clips of well-known preachers. I don't know. Like when the eclipse was coming out and they were commanding spirits to go back into the ocean. I don't know. I'm a Pentecostal. I'm not a cessationist. I don't know what you're doing. I don't know why you have like a Lord of the Rings staff I don't know. I don't know. I don't know why we're talking about cheesesteaks and somebody put apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers, etc. I don't know. They're a unique breed, the Christians. They're different. I don't get it. Christine said Chili Willy Cheesesteaks is the best in the country, located in Beaver Falls, Pennsylvania. I don't know. Sounds like your account was hacked by Chili Willy Cheesesteaks. I've never heard of that. There's Ishka Bibbles, there's Gino's and Pat's, the two originals that get no respect in Philadelphia, even though, in my opinion, they're very good. Anyway, I know, Stephanie. I'm telling you, the best one I've ever had is probably in California last night. Had a great time. Thanks for everybody that came to the meeting. What an awesome crowd to preach to. Nikki, good to see you. Went to your meeting in Dallas, Texas, in the Honky Tonk, and I'm going to your Uncle Ted's healing crusade. And then it went up. Yeah, that might have been it, Griffin. That's what happens when weed is legal. I could smell it heavy in the parking lot, so maybe that's why I enjoyed the food so much, and maybe that's why I ate so much of it. I had cheese, what they call in New Jersey disco fries, what they call in Montreal poutine, but it's disco fries because they use mozzarella. Montreal, they use cheese curd. French fries, mozzarella, and then hot gravy. That was my side. Then a cheesesteak, and then that milkshake. So maybe I'm in a good mood because my blood sugar is around 16 to 1700 this morning. I don't know if it's normal, but when I woke up, my foot was black. So I might have had too much sugar yesterday. It's not a racial joke. It's a diabetes joke. Anyway, let's see what's going on in the world. My mom always wanted to own a Mercedes. I thought this was a very, like, uplifting, encouraging story. Roll it.
Growing up poor, my mom always wanted to own a Mercedes-Benz. I think she just associated that car with success and also something that was unattainable to her. That's why after I closed my first big deal, I blindfolded my mother and brought her outside at 72 years old to show her the Mercedes-Benz that I just bought. Because anything's possible if you want it bad enough. And one day, she could probably own one too if she applied herself. But sometimes, people just need a little motivation to take that first step. I've even offered my mother a first side hustle detailing that Mercedes for extra cash, which she can use as a down payment to my online course, which I've offered to her at a family discount. I'm rooting for my mother, and just remember, you're never too old for it to be your turn.
Great job, Ryan Long, for inspiring your 72-year-old mother. Next.
I'm calm during chaos.
Pause, back to me. This is not parody, and I'm not going to mock this lady if she was an actual minister, but when I was saying that the Christians, they're just strange to me. This is a lady in her car. This is a video she recorded. The internet is flooded with these. Take it away.
I'm calm during chaos. Have peace in the storms, it's true. And I pray for my patience, yeah.
Back to me.
Made strong in my weak.
If I was on a date with that lady, if we were driving at 65 miles an hour, I would open the door and tuck and roll onto the highway. Where are you? Why are you shutting a car? Can you record that somewhere? All right, let's start from the beginning.
I'm calm during chaos. Have peace in the storms, it's true. And I pray for my patience, yeah.
Oof.
Made strong in my weakness.
Back to me.
Got love.
The eyes, when she says, yeah, there's like a lot going on behind those eyes. It reminds me when you would look at that, like, footage of dictators from Southeast Asia, like those kind of eyes. Like, I feel like if that lady had the ability, she would send many people to concentration camps. It's a lot to read into a nice Christian song, but that's how I feel. All right, let me watch it one more time from the beginning. I'll try to make it all the way through.
I'm calm during chaos,
right.
Have peace in the storms, it's true, mm-hmm. And I pray for my patience, yeah.
Oof.
Made strong.
Those eyes run for the hills.
Got love that is fierce and true, and I know that His grace does save me, no matter what I go through.
Pause, back to me. Don't you think some people get saved because the devil's like, you can have her? I think she'll do more harm. She'll do more good for me doing harm for you. Anyway, let's watch it from the beginning again.
I'm calm during chaos. Have peace in the storms, it's true. And I pray for my patience, yeah. Made strong in my weakness. Got love that is fierce and true. And I know that His grace does save me. No matter what I go through, I know everything's gonna be quite alright. Cause He's the one who's in control now. And I am guided by His bright, bright light. And thank God for that, because when I take the wheel... It's not great.
I didn't watch it to the end. Took a turn. She should have. Oh, wait. Brad wrote on the app, you're not a compassionate person when you aren't under the anointing. I mean, if you want to take shots at me, if you've downloaded the Revival Today app to judge me. I mean, you have a point. I don't know, Brad, where compassion would really come in. It's, you know, it's like I'm showing a video of her bleeding out. And we're like laughing as she's passing away or battling a sickness. You know, you uploaded that. It's not like somebody filmed you and we're making fun of you. And it was like a private moment. Like you were getting ready in your bathroom and you're deciding to work out a new song that you have an idea for. You uploaded that. I don't know. I didn't take it. I don't know where compassion comes in. So, Brad, what am I supposed to do in this situation? You know, let's pray for her. You know, she's obviously going through it. Lord, I don't know how you'd have compassion. What's there to have compassion for? She's doing all right. She's got hair extensions. She has a car. She has a jacket. She has a nice phone that's uploaded to the internet. Where's the compassion come in? She's not a, like, Rwandan orphan. You know what I like about my outfit today? It's a military jacket, but then with a hot pink t-shirt and then military green and hot pink hat. So you can't tell whether I'm a Republican or an ally to the LGBT community. My arms are outstretched to all. Let's watch that again from the top.
I'm calm during chaos. Have peace in the storms, it's true. And I pray for my patience, yeah. Made strong in my weakness. Got love that is fierce and true, and I know that His grace does save me. No matter what I go through, I know everything's gonna be quite alright. He's the one who's in control now, and I am guided by His bright, bright light.
Pause. See that face? Memorize that face, because she's about to go nuts. So when you, that's like, my mouth is smiling, but my eyes are murderous. Anybody that's married to a lady, you know, when you see that face, it's time to make sure you're out of arm's length. Okay, so to me, this would be a good time to end the video. You sang, you finished, nice pose, and scene. But no, we're going to add in a little... I feel like the end of this video should trigger red flag gun laws. Probably they should take her driver's license away. I mean, she's basically threatening vehicular manslaughter at the end, is she not? What does she say? Go ahead, roll it.
Thank God for that, because when I take the wheel... it's not great.
I feel like anybody, any man watching that from Saudi Arabia would be like, see, this is why we don't let them drive. This is why we make them be with their brother. This is why we don't allow them out in public. I feel like that lady set female progress back 15 years. Let's watch one more time.
I'm calm during chaos. Have peace in the storms, it's true. And I pray for my patience, yeah.
Pause. That's a good point. Karen on YouTube said she's wearing a wedding ring. Wow. Can we get her husband on the program? Just ask what was going through his head. I want that with me the rest of my life. No, I'm sure she's a great mother. Go ahead, continue.
Made strong in my weakness. Got love that is fierce and true. And I know that His grace does save me. No matter what I go through, I know everything's gonna be quite alright.
Is that a wedding ring? Well, now it's out of the... Can you back it up like 2 seconds? I don't know if it's a wedding ring. Might be a promise ring. There's no diamond, right? Yeah, I didn't think she was married. She doesn't give off married vibes. She's a wild horse who's not been yet been put in the stable, so to speak. Continue.
Things gonna be quite all right. He's the one who's in control now, and I am guided by His bright, bright light.
Pause. I'm not a singer, and sometimes I think people are good singers, and Adonis tells me they're not good singers. Are there any musicians here? Voice sounded okay, right? Scale of 1 to 10, 7 or 8? 7. Yeah, not bad for the car. So there, see, there's some compassion. She said, okay, you know what, Brad? I'll take your advice. She seems like a nice lady. She, shirts on front ways, tags in the back, got that right. Seems kind. Car's clean. How am I doing, Brad? Oh, okay. Rosalie, who's a friend of mine on the app, I follow her on social. She's actually married with kids and has a business. So, Rosalie, is this video an outlier? Like, because if you follow her, you're not nuts. So she has, like, good business videos and stuff? See, what ends up happening, Lisa Barna, makeup's on point. See, we're being positive today. You know what the problem is? Many of you that started following me, like in 2018, 2019, I was invited nowhere. Now I get invited places, and there's people that are there that I vaguely remember making fun of on a video. And I can't remember what I said, but when I look at them, I can tell they remember what I said. So I just get the feeling I'm going to bump into this lady somewhere, but I'm not going to remember why she's looking at me with, like, throat slash eyes. She's online comedian mommy. Oh, okay, so she's doing comedy. Is that true? She has a clothing company that uplifts moms. She makes funny videos. Okay. See, that puts it in different perspective. I thought she was being serious. If she's doing that to be funny, then it cuts the legs out of the whole thing. I thought that was like a serious Christian video. Good to know. If this lady or her angry husband is watching, I retract anything that you found offensive. Keep up the good work. I'm sure you have more followers than me. Keep it up. Clarita says she's 506 vocals. All right. I'll back off. Somebody said, I prefer your preaching to you making fun of her. There's things I need to do for me to stay interested in life. These broadcasts aren't for you. That's why I checked the news. We put a disclaimer up to please not watch. All right. Next. Short but intense civic education lesson. This is in Germany with protesters blocking the streets. I don't think they're Palestinian. I think it's a climate change thing. And this big, I think Turkish. I'm going to guess Turkish. This guy's had enough. Roll it. Thomas from the river, if he never gave his life to the Lord. Sassit. Well, why is the lady taking up for the people? People need to go to work. You know, boss, I can tell by how that guy's dressed with the white Michael Scott fun jeans and red socks and loafers. He was not dressed this morning looking for trouble. But he got, here we are. Continue. Man, that guy's got good strength. German Michael Scott over there. This guy doing work. One arm. Should have left him. Those two should become like permanent friends. All right. I don't know why that I'm telling you, somebody's sitting on a gold mine. If they could invent some type of technology, I'm giving you ideas here. If you could invent some type of technology that emits something non-lethal that would clear the road, whether it's a high-frequency sound that hurts the ears, if you could put something, install it in the grill of a car where when people are blocking the road, you hit a button and it clears the road. You couldn't do tear gas. That's illegal. You can't be like Batman-type stuff. But I'm thinking more. Hey, Pastor John, good to see you. I'm thinking more, because this happens every election year now. I'm thinking more it would have to be like an audio thing, because there'd be no way to prove it. It wouldn't pick up on video. Taser you can get in trouble for. Microwave gun, look it up, Logan said. Kind of an aggressive comment. Microwave gun, look it up. What is a microwave gun? Again, it's water cannons. I don't know if they're legal. Okay, Jonathan on Facebook. Joe Biden can't believe I'm prophesying in America, and he has proof of it for the golden G. See, that's that kind of prophetic talk that I don't, you lose me. You might as well be talking in Mandarin. Joe Biden can't believe I'm prophesying in America, and he has proof of it, for the golden G. I don't know. It's like something you'd find scratched into the wall of an insane asylum. Next. FAA has issued a ground stop advisory on all Alaskan airline flights without mentioning the reason. Does anybody know Now, that happened a while back. So does anybody know, has more information come out? If you guys look up, if you could do a little production work for me, what, why are all American airline flights grounded by the FAA? Is it a terrorist threat or what? Maybe at this point, terrorists are afraid to hijack American planes because they go down anyway. They've just been falling apart in midair. Next. Yeah, Wilson said long-range acoustic devices, LRAD, from what I've seen used by police. You're welcome, Jonathan. I don't know what you mean, though. He said, thank you for reading that. You're an amazing preacher. Maybe it's my own reading comprehension problem. I don't know. All right, go ahead. They gave me a ticket for free to Chicago. An illegal immigrant from Russia who has been living in New York City for the past year received a free plane ticket to Chicago, sharing that he wants to see a new city and feel a new vibe. He then expressed plans to visit L.A. with another free ticket from the Special Government Service Company, who gives them out. Here, we're all paying for our own tickets like idiots. So this is what, back to me real quick before we play it. When I went to go visit the border wearing this exact same jacket, that's what they told me. That's why I was actually going to scout it out to go do a crusade on the border, but there aren't really people on the border, like immigrants, to go reach. They're processed and out in about 24 to 30 hours, and they give them a ticket to go fly wherever they want. I don't know, and I guess we're paying for it tax-wise. Andrew said, isn't shooting somebody in the leg technically non-lethal? No. You will definitely go to prison. If there were people blocking the road and you popped out of your car and just started putting shots in people's legs, you're going to jail for a long time. All right, play the video.
Yes. They give me a ticket for free to Chicago. I fly tomorrow.
For free?
For free.
Possibly. Why are you going to Chicago?
Should have given you a ticket to a barber. Continue.
Go.
I try to find any work because I'm homeless immigrant from Russian Federation. Yo, my name is Mark Mirian.
You're from Russia?
Yeah.
Who gave you the ticket?
So even the illegal immigrants have like screen names and stuff that they're trying to, the guy's been in the country like 40 hours. He's trying to get a YouTube channel going. What was his name again that he promoted? Play it from the beginning. As in yes. America, we're pitching
they
a YouTube
give me
channel.
A ticket for free to Chicago. I fly tomorrow.
For free?
Free.
Why are you going to Chicago?
I try to find any work because...
I have a feeling why he's not welcome in Russia. Continue.
I'm homeless immigrant from Russian Federation. Yo, my name is Mark Mirian.
You're from Russia?
Yeah.
Who gave you the ticket to go to Chicago?
Chicago? No, this special government service company.
That side has a great fade. And then when the barber got to that side, he must have had to, like, go to a child support hearing or something. He's like, I'm out of here. I did half your head. You're on your own. Continue.
You know, they try to help new people, new immigrants who come.
You're excited to go to Chicago?
Yeah, because I want to see new city. It will be, I want to feel new vibe, new atmosphere, and maybe try to find new contacts, new friends.
So, you were in New York for 1 year,
yes.
And now you got a free ticket, and now you're going to go to Chicago.
Da. And then after Chicago, I'm going to Los Angeles because it was my first city in my life before New York.
Did you get a free ticket to go to Los Angeles as well?
Yeah, if I ask them. But at this moment, I have like one friend in Chicago, and it will be new experience for me, you know?
So you stayed in New York for a year, then you're going to go to Chicago, yeah. And then you want to go to L.A.
Yeah, I try to get any work to Chicago to collect, you know, and to fly to... But maybe something happens with me in Chicago. Maybe I find good work, good friends, and I will be living in Chicago. So I don't know about future.
Next. Boston Dynamics just unveiled its new humanoid robot called Atlas. Now, if you missed the rapture, wish you all the best. Watch this. Oh, just a robot having a nap. Seems harmless. What? Who knew Terminator 2 would come into real life? You know, they're making like thousands of those. Next. Hey, Pastor Ray on X. Good to see you. One of the 10 best Americans on alive currently, Harmeet Dhillon, at a COVID-19 hearing. I think the biggest thing that Congress could do right now is to overrule by legislation the outdated Jacobson versus Massachusetts. That's what's used for forced vaccination. So she went to testify before the House yesterday about putting things in place so that 2020 could never happen again. Roll it.
Thank you for the question, Congressman McClintock. I think the biggest thing that Congress could do right now is to overrule by legislation the outdated precedent, Jacobson versus Massachusetts. I hear people in this hearing praising it. At the time Jacobson versus Massachusetts was the law, black people couldn't eat at the same places as white people. People like me from Punjab weren't allowed to buy property in the United States. We've had a lot of outdated laws and dark times in our country, and that precedent is one of them. And so when I hear passionate advocates for abortion cite it as a constitutional right, it is legally premised on tiered scrutiny under the 14th Amendment, which is scrutiny developed by progressive courts to protect our constitutional rights. And that is all I'm asking for, is that that well-established tiered scrutiny be applied today in 2024 to the problems of 2024, not the problems of 150 years ago.
My time is limited, but I'd be very, very interested in seeing your suggestions in writing on this subject. I think the Congress, looking back on this now, can see the folly.
What a stupid thing to say by that McClintock guy. Our time's limited, but I'd love to see your stuff in writing. Then friggin' look it up and read it. You had her fly from California to Washington, D.C. to tell you in person, dummy. I say that with all due respect to our leaders. Next. I urge Congress to enact legislation that limits the federal government's ability to use outdated legislation and rulings to curtail our constitutional freedoms. A little bit of a lengthy video, but this lady's worth, this is the lady that represented churches and won cases in California. She helped me when I kept preaching in March and April. Good lady. Very, very, I admire and respect Harmeet Dhillon. Roll it.
Good afternoon, Chairman Roy, Ranking Member Scanlon, and members of this committee. Thank you for inviting me to testify before you on a topic that I believe to be the most significant civil rights crisis of my lifetime. The use of so-called COVID emergency to eviscerate Americans' most cherished constitutionally protected freedoms. During the pandemic, we witnessed the radical dismantling of the guardrails that the framers of our Constitution specifically designed to rein in imperious government actors. In the guise of emergency, government officials instituted unlimited executive fiats to control and curtail every aspect of our lives. These actions by the government were not narrowly tailored nor based on credible science, and as such, the government's escalating and often arbitrary restrictions were not meaningfully limited. The government closed our schools, locked down our houses of worship, destroyed our small businesses, criminalized our free speech, banned travel, kept us from our loved ones at their most desperate hours, even shut down the beaches of Orange County and the skate parks so that children could not play. The government wrested unchecked and unprecedented control from the American people and the vast majority of American elected officials from both parties assumed their heretofore unimaginable powers with no qualms about history, precedent, or the consequences. Thankfully, due to a wave of legal challenges against these restrictions, the Supreme Court eventually issued rulings that, piece by piece, returned some measure of protection to our threatened First Amendment rights, while others remain exposed and eroded to this day. COVID demonstrated just how vulnerable these rights are without affirmative protection from judicially unchecked government overreach. At any given time today, a state or federal government
Pause
official
real quick, bring
could
it back to me. If my YouTube channel ends up getting taken down for this, just bear in mind that YouTube would take down my channel for showing footage of a congressional hearing without comment, which is all I'm doing. Roll it.
Declare an emergency or fabricate some unfounded excuse and suspend our fundamental rights once again. Most courts will not stop them, as we have unfortunately seen. It is imperative that Congress intervene to make sure that the COVID legal history cannot and will not repeat itself. One of the most egregious violations of our First Amendment freedoms was the treatment of religious Americans as second-class citizens, as vectors of disease. From the very beginning of the pandemic, governors across the country discriminately labeled houses of worship, and by extension, the First Amendment as quote-unquote non-essential, while at the same time leaving their secular counterparts open for business. In my state, California, marijuana, liquor, and big box retailers were deemed essential, but God was banned. There were different rules
back
for the elites.
Insane that a Sikh from Punjab would stand up for church rights while you had pastors like Andy Stanley condemning any pastor that wanted to stay open. And you had anybody that understood the law feeling the correct way. What a time to be alive. Continue.
Compared to the people as well. A member of this committee, Congresswoman Bush, held protests on the steps of the Capitol while Nancy Pelosi barred our client, a Reverend Patrick Mahoney, from praying at the same place. The Center for American Liberty and my law firm represented several American faithful citizens in their fight to live according to their religious beliefs. In three of these cases, the United States Supreme Court agreed with us. Gish versus Newsom, South Bay United Pentecostal Church versus Newsom, and Tandon versus Newsom. We represented pastors and congregants in California who did everything they could to keep their churches' doors open safely. They offered distancing, they offered sanitization, they offered masking, but none of it was good enough for the government. This discrimination against religious Americans did not end once restrictions lifted. We currently represent three individuals who were fired from the North Carolina Symphony, where they requested religious exemptions to the vaccine mandate. All three musicians submitted exemption requests that included guarantees they would take additional social distancing and masking measures to avoid violating anybody else's rights. But this was not good enough. The symphony denied the requests and fired these musicians who remain fired to this day, even though the symphony has lifted its vaccine mandate. As a result of these discriminatory actions, these artists lost their livelihoods and the American dream. These violations of our civil rights were made possible by the lack of due process and judicial scrutiny during the pandemic. When governors invoked emergency status, many federal judges threw all three standards of scrutiny, rational basis, intermediate, and strict scrutiny, to the wind in the name of an emergency. I heard judge after judge chillingly dismiss rulings in our cases challenging government overreach. This complete disregard for a critical check was a result of an outdated Supreme Court ruling, Jacobson versus Massachusetts, which hails from even before the Jim Crow era in our country and yet remains the law in this country to this day. Jacobson handed unbridled power to the government to declare when an emergency occurred and what to do about it. There was no room for judges to make their own rules based on facts, experts, and the law. Executive fiat was rubber stamped and our fundamental rights abridged. In conclusion, I urge Congress to enact legislation that limits the federal government's ability to use outdated legislation and rulings like Jacobson and others to curtail our constitutional freedoms and to apply instead modern tiered scrutiny and due process analysis developed by the courts. No emergency, especially one defined by the government, should warrant the erosion of our freedoms and a complete disregard for the judicial scrutiny the courts use to preserve them in every other instance. Thank you.
Thanks, Million Dollar Babe. That's her name, by the way. I'm not flirting. Jonathan, I love the 35 questions for those who hate the prosperity gospel. Thank you. Yeah, she is, Lisa. She's a great lady. We're still efforting to get her live in studio for Check the News. Next. Roll it.
Don't.
Can you imagine if they actually ran that on TV for the ad? Next. Okay, now let's get to the series. So if you're joining us, by the way, you can see me in Los Angeles, California, live tonight, 7 o'clock. Today is update on the Moldovan sword swallower. This story will not go away. Okay, so I wrote, I stand with Alex Malaga, but it's Magala, I think. I misspelled it. I stand. So now The sword swallower, back to me. If you haven't watched the broadcast 2 days ago, you should watch it. I don't have time to reset that. We'd be here another hour. You'd think this would just kind of start to blow over. Well, nobody took a greater beating than you know, this guy, they called him a male stripper. I know people in this room that may have been guilty of saying the same thing. He's not happy because it's not a strip show. And the other thing is, you can, Kristen, is that true, Kristen? What was I going to say? It is hard. Like, after you read this, it's hard to blame him because he does the exact same act, performance everywhere he goes. Like, that exact thing with the finish where he drops down and, you know, the sword stops, like, an inch from the bottom. Okay, good to know. Don't click the link. Well, maybe it's good that I misspelled it. If I misspelled it, it shouldn't go to anything bad. So, he issued a statement, and to me, this kind of starts to sound like anybody that released things calling him a stripper and all that might get sued, which is why we have changed our T-shirt that we're giving away. By the way, can we show the T-shirt we're giving away to our monthly partners and those that give? I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was a Moldovan sword swallower. There's the flags. There's the final issue. We got rid of, what's his face? Bill Johnson. Swapped him out for John Lindell. And then we got the Moldovan flag on there. So we're going to send this shirt. You can have another shirt that's inappropriate literally to wear anywhere. But I get the feeling I'm going to be seeing these in my meetings at church. I love seeing these when I'm preaching because I automatically know I have a friend in the crowd and someone that in no way could ever be offended. So anyway, we'll send those today. All right. Let's see. See, on YouTube, I'm reading comments. I've never seen it. I feel repulsed at the subject. That makes me feel like I might need to reset what we're talking about. Do we have the ability to play the performance? All right, I'll just go. So here's the statement. Full statement from Alex Magala, the sword-swallowing performer at the center of the Mark Driscoll controversy. Quote, in response to recent criticisms of Stronger Men's Conference produced by James River Church, I feel compelled to clarify the context and intention behind my specialty act. Now, back to me real quick. I'm not saying that he's not a good writer, but this has the feel of a professionally, like something a lawyer wrote or somebody professional, which makes me feel like somebody's about to get sued. Because this is like, whoever wrote this, the way they framed it and flipped it back on the church is like a professional writer and like a consultant firm, in my opinion. So it's very, very well written. Go ahead. In response to recent criticisms produced by James River Church, I feel compelled to clarify the context and intention behind my specialty act. My performance, which some have controversially likened to inappropriate entertainment, is deeply rooted in a historical and cultural tradition that dates back over 1,200 years. Now you've made it like a racial thing. This is like excellent framing. And has since become a respected discipline showcasing human strength and agility. Pastor Mark Driscoll's remarks. Now check the turn this takes in the writing. What are the chances of this? Pastor Mark Driscoll's remarks about my act failed to recognize the difference between a male striptease and a stunt performance rooted in art and sport. Only an uninformed person would draw a comparison between my act and an inappropriate performance. I feel that this danger act is perfect for the Stronger Men's Conference. It provides inspiration to the audience and permission for them to reach new heights of what's possible in their lives. Continue. Check this out. What are the chances of this? My mentor, Dan Meyer, is a leader of Sword Swallowers Association International. Now, I'll be honest with you. I didn't know that was a thing. Can you guys look up sword? Be careful. Make sure the safe search is on. But look up sword swallow. You can put the article back up. Let me try it again. My mentor, Dan Meyer, is a leader of Sword Swallowers Association. My mentor, Dan Meyer, is a leader of Sword Swallowers. My mentor, Dan Meyer, is a leader of Sword Swallowers Association International. Now, let me tell you something. As somebody that went through 5 years of speech therapy, I'm proud of myself for being able to read that for two reasons, without laughing and at all, because those were the words I had to work on. S-S-H. I couldn't pronounce them. So Sword Swallowers would have been a nightmare. It's still kind of a nightmare, but I can read it out. My mentor, Dan Meyer, is a leader of Sword Swallowers Association International. Good job, Jonathan. A multiple Guinness World Record holder in sword swallowing. And just so happens to be a check this out. Just so happens to be a member of Pastor Mark Driscoll's own congregation. So the head of Sword Swallowers Association International is a member of Mark Driscoll's church, and Mark Driscoll just went full on and attacked not just Alex, but all sword swallowers. So this is going to cause problems at the church, you would think. Just so happens to be a member of Pastor Mark Driscoll's own congregation. What a turn. Dan says it wasn't a raunchy male pole dance or stripper performance. Alex is the top of his field as a master in the classical 12th century martial arts acrobatic discipline called Chinese pole acrobatics, which he performed at the Olympics. Can I have anybody that works at this ministry that's not offstage laughing? Holy moly. It's like I'm reading this in detention. Called Chinese pole acrobatics. Another thing I didn't know existed, to be honest with you, which he performed at the Olympics. So this Alex guy you're finding out is not some nothing. You know, he was on America's Got Talent. I think he was on Britain's Got Talent. He performed at the Olympics. No, wait. No, this is performed at the Olympics. Okay. This is way different than a male strip. What a thing to read. What happened to the world? This is way different than a male stripper. That's something you don't say a lot. I'm going to start using that phrase a lot. Sir, are you enjoying your spaghetti? Yes, it's way different than a male stripper. This is way different than a male stripper. It's like comparing classical ballet with striptease. No comparison, although in a way you just compared it. The convention hired Alex because the theme was strong men, and Alex is the best at what he does. I am a Christian. See, now it's taken in. Now you treated a guy like he's demon-possessed. He has the Jezebel spirit and all that stuff that they said, and he's offended. I'm a Christian, and I've always aimed to use my talents to inspire and entertain audiences in a way that respects my faith. The act in question was designed to be a celebration of physical human achievements and is aligned with the James River Church's purpose in bringing others into the light of God. All right. It's essential to approach such performances with an understanding of their intention rather than reducing them to mere entertainment. So there it is. It takes a turn. Show of emoji hands. Show of emoji thumb up or thumb down. Do you think somebody's getting sued? Not by much, but I'm going to give it a thumbs up. I think like 55%, barely thumbs up. I think there's a chance that he's taken such offense to that, and then it is in a way it's defamatory. You know what they said? Yeah, there's mostly thumbs up. Ninja Buddha goes thumbs down. Brian Porzio says thumbs down. Brian, you live in Arizona, I think. Did you know that the head of the Sword Swallowers Association International is in Arizona? Well, Rudy said, but why did the classical arts Alex guy take his shirt off before doing the act? Only nudity makes it work? It's not, you know, a man not wearing a shirt. It's like if LeBron James takes his shirt off on his way to the bench. It's not nudity. So, again, don't get the idea that I'm going to be having that at Revival Today Church anytime soon. I'm not saying we never will. Who knows? Nobody knows the future. I could develop a drug problem and start making poor decisions. We don't know. But Sarah said he's forcing a public apology. Yes, at best that. I don't think he's going to get it. See, John Lindell's in bad shape off of this, and Mark Driscoll now's in bad shape. So it looked like it was just going to be Mark Driscoll could take a shot at it. And you know, it's not his event and he's leaving. Interesting, isn't it? Mark Driscoll, like, took a shot. You're at somebody else's thing and then you leave. And you're like, go back to Arizona. No big deal. But it turns out that guy's sensei, sword-swallowing sensei, is in Mark's church. So that was yesterday. Sally Monday, who lives in Arizona, wrote OMG with a cactus. Cindy said, Mark, Pastor Mark, didn't defame him personally. The shirt comes off so you can, that the sword's not being hidden and going down his throat. That's a good point. Driscoll is going live at 3 to discuss what he said in the post earlier. Shoot. 3 what? Eastern? I would love to watch that live and break it down. But I'm probably not. I agree, Johnny. I mean, here's what I heard. You want to hear more about what I heard? Because I know people that were at the event. I didn't know I knew people that were at the event, but then people reached out to me. So what they did, it was a men's event in an arena, and they had feats of strength and ability that men did. So, 3 p.m. Arizona time. Well, I can't kill that much time. I mean, I could, but I'm not. So, it'll be interesting to hear I know what I'm going to be broadcasting tomorrow. That's true, Lisa. She said Mark didn't call him out. He said the Jezebel spirit is already here. It's true. He didn't. It would probably be tough to sue him because he didn't say, like, this man's evil. Jessica on Facebook said, hey, Jonathan. I don't know. Are you, like, getting my attention to tell me something else or just saying hello? Either way, hello. My problem with the entire thing is the emphasis on the entertainment aspect heavy in the church right now instead of, yeah. You know, again, I'm not defending what happened, but I'll tell you the thought process. It's a men's event. So they had, like, I don't know if they had these things specifically, but it wasn't like they just had that guy do that. There were weightlifters, you know, stuff like that, power lifters, karate people breaking boards. They just did it to kind of like, do an entertainment thing for a men's event in an arena, it wasn't in the service. It wasn't like they did praise and worship, then had that guy come up, then go to speaking. That's the other thing I found out is when John Lindell got upset and said, you could have talked to me earlier, that didn't all happen at the same time. Like, that happened in the morning, and then they were together all day, and then Mark spoke at night, Pastor Mark Driscoll. So in that case, it is like he could have had a chat with John Lindell. So, like, listen, do you want to address this, or would you like me to do it? So I can see it both guys' way. But I'm just glad I'm out of the mix, other than sort of getting myself involved by having that t-shirt. Can you guys grab me, Dr. Michael Brown, that I put his tweet up yesterday, can you grab me his tweet about it? It'll be one of his last two or three tweets. Carol Warner said, is this the new power team? Fingers crossed that it's not. John Lindell is set to make a statement after talking to executive leadership in his fellowship. When's that, Kyle? It does have elements of Will Smith and Chris Rock to it. It's the Christian version of the Chris Rock Will Smith thing. So knowing all that, like from Alex Magala's standpoint, you know, he was doing, actually, you can watch a video where he does the exact same performance at America's Got Talent. Like, exact. So you can't blame him. You booked him to do the exact thing. It's not like, like one time. I know of an evangelistic event where they had in a secular performer to sing and to help draw the crowd. It was like a famous young singer. And he was, you know, he's obviously told it was a Christian event. If you could please, you know, they had like a song for him to sing that didn't have any cursing or like filthy lyrics, which I'm not for this. But he got up, wore like a gay pride t-shirt, and sang the foulest, filthiest song that he had recorded, just to like stick it to the event. Now that's different. Even though, yeah, you shouldn't, if you're gonna have people in that don't share your views and don't care about you, there's a chance that can happen. But this guy didn't do that. It's not like he has like a different performance he does, and then he to stick it to the church, ripped his shirt off and all that stuff. This is what he did, and then what somebody commented, they said the reason he takes his shirt off is so you can see that he's not hiding the sword in the shirt, that you can see that it actually, you know, he's actually in danger. Roosevelt said, he said it wasn't a rebuke. He just said the Jezebel spirit was there. Yes, but if a pastor has me in to preach, like next week I'm going to be in Washington State. If I go preach for that pastor and they introduce me to preach and I take the mic and say, before I get into my sermon, I just want to tell everyone that the Jezebel spirit's already in this church. I fired a shot. There's no way, like, no, I wasn't talking about you, like, in particular, pastor. Vivian said, how does any of it glorify Christ? I'm not making the argument. Again, I've never had any sword swallowing in any event I've ever done. Do you have the act? Okay, so listen. I'm only showing this again. Now that we know Alex's perspective, that it isn't like a strip tease and stuff. It's, and the pole isn't to pole dance. The pole, I'm telling you from his perspective. Now, personally, I'm on nobody's side. I'm just looking to move a few t-shirts. But from his perspective, now that you watch it, that he's, you know, for him saying, I'm a Christian, I'm not a stripper anymore, and all that stuff. Yeah, it isn't like a sensual thing. The pole is because he's going to climb to the top with a sword in his mouth, impressive, and then wrap his legs around and go down and stop 1 inch from the from killing himself. So it's what did he call it in the statement? It's a danger act. He's right. It's a danger act. It's not a sensual act. He wasn't like making like crude gestures and stuff. And if that's true what the person wrote, that you take the shirt off to show that the sword's not being hidden. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I'm new to the whole sword swallowing game. I don't know much about it, but I believe what he wrote. Let's watch again from that perspective. Pause back to me. Now again, that is stripper-ish clothing, but he's also Eastern European. And the difference between stripper male stripper clothing and Eastern European men's clothing in fit and sparkliness is pretty close. Again, I'm trying to see it from Alex's side. So, continue. Pause. I mean, that's not, I don't think that, like, from what I read now, that you're showing feats of strength. That is pretty impressive to grab a flagpole and like walk up imaginary steps. Like if I tried that, it would just be like grabbing a flagpole and slowly collapsing into a heap on the ground. I mean, so I do see it his way. Again, I'm not going soft I'm just seeing it from a different perspective. Because earlier in the program, if you're watching, I was admonished to be more compassionate. So you wanted a new compassionate Jonathan? You're getting it. Rhonda from my church said, not again. Rhonda, don't leave Revival Today Church. This will not be happening. If it does, it'll be at a Dallas's women's event. Continue. Pause, back to me. I wonder what the difference of the reaction would be if this was at a women's event. It's like, is it worse at a men's event or is it worse at a women's event? Let's throw it over to the crowd. Worse at a women's event or worse at a men's event? Continue. All right. I mean, that's not sensual. If anything, it's threatening. You're like waving a sword at the audience. Okay, we see it. You have a sword. And I'll be honest with you. Back to me. Okay, now that part, you could probably do without. But again, you don't, I don't know. Like eating a sandwich, you probably want to like moisten it up. You don't want to just sharp. I don't know. I don't want to look into it too much. And you know, I'll be honest with you. If I was in that kind of shape, you'd never catch me with a shirt on. I'd walk around like a 1980s WWF wrestler for the rest of my life. So I get it. All right, continue. Pause, back to me. If you're just tuning in, this happened at a church meeting. So that's my interest in breaking it down. It was a trending news story globally. So we're not just putting on this show to enjoy it. Continue. Pause. People keep saying, I agree, Tony. Teresa said, this was in a men's conference lineup. Didn't anyone Google him before he showed up? Yes. This is what he was, that's why he's upset. He's doing the exact thing he was contracted to do, and then you treat him like he came in and he was supposed to sing Amazing Grace and he ripped his shirt off and swallowed a sword. He does, that's his only act, as far as I know. Like that exact act. Continue. Pause back to me. Some other thoughts. You know, this was $199 to attend. I don't understand the draw. Is it like $18.90? You know, like to go watch a circus performance? You can watch that on YouTube. I don't know. I don't. Like for me, I hate going to things. Anything, basically. I'm going to try to go to some more baseball games this year. I enjoy that a little bit. I mean, I would never pay $200 to go. But that's me. Apparently, 6,000 other people disagree. Continue. Now, this is impressive. What do you do if you have to sneeze? It's just over. No, that is, let me tell you, that is impressive. Now this is amazing. Big finish. Big finish like the lady in the car. Look how close he stepped to the ground. Little box shooting Kleenex box with flames. I'm gonna tell you, that's a big deal to watch that in Missouri. When all you've ever been to is the Branson go-kart track. That'll get a rise out of the crowd. Well, I gotta say, pause. At the time, if Mark Driscoll, here's another thing you have to think of if you're John Lindell. Or from, if this is something you have to think of from John Lindell's perspective. The crowd wasn't like enraged and like storming out at that point. It got a receptive response. It was not during the church service part. So knowing that, that does kind of make it different. I don't know. I'm glad I'm not in that whole mess. The more after all this, it's like strengthened my commitment to basically just preach and pray for people and avoid anything else. So does anybody have the times? Okay, so Mark Driscoll's going on at 3 o'clock. Where is he going on? I need to get this all hammered down because I have my afternoon planned out. Ernst says, JD, you do know. You know there was nothing wrong with this. Putting words in my mouth. Colette said, it's weird why it occurred. Yeah, that's what it has. It doesn't have, yeah, like if wrong, weird, yes. Wrong, you can debate. Weird, it's weird. It's out of place. Like, I don't know. Julie said, you don't need this in your church, Jonathan. No, yeah, I don't know who I gave the impression. First of all, you think this guy's going to come to my church after these last three videos I did? Probably want to take a sword and run it through my sternum. Oh, yeah. Thanks for keeping me on track. Jessica said, what about the Michael Brown post? Okay, so here's his take, which was basically my take. Just much better written. I've been asked by lots of folks today about the debacle with the sword swallower performing shirtless. See, with a pole dance, I don't know that you can say that. Like, watching it after reading what Alex wrote, pole dance is a stretch. At a church men's conference and about Mark Driscoll's public rebuke of what happened. Some quick responses. Even if the church had no idea this guy had been a male stripper, there is no possible justification for his pole dancing shirtless performance at a men's conference. None. This is completely outrageous, and the only proper response from the pastor would be a deep apology and a complete repudiation of what happened. This is madness. Back to me. Again, I totally agreed with that yesterday until I read Alex's statement. And now I don't know. Like, if you're like, I'm a Christian, this is a 1,200-year-old art. And it's a feat of strength. And yeah, I think once you throw the former stripper in and then there's a pole and he's shirtless, but that is not connected to this. And for him to say, I'm a Christian, it's kind of mean to like keep bringing that up in a way. Again, this is the compassionate Jonathan you wanted. I'm just going to take up for everybody now. Okay, let's keep reading. A colleague of mine, I want to say to all the people that go to my church that go to the seniors brunch, there's a possibility that the next Saturday seniors brunch, Alex McGall is going to be there. Horrifying you. Number two, a colleague of mine goes to this church and knows the pastor and told me the pastor preaches holiness and purity. That's true. This makes the situation all the more ugly and inexcusable. Again, there is no possible justification for this in the house of God, other than it's not in the house of God, I don't think. Wasn't that an arena? I don't think it's in their church. See, like, back to me. Like, if somebody wanted to be hardcore, like, we showed UFC 300 in our 107 building. There's no preaching or anything. We use the big room for guys to have a men's fellowship and watch UFC 300. Well, I'm not... It's not like it's an R-rated movie that I already know people are going to curse and stuff. Somebody said, where is the revival? It's not here right now. We're just doing a broadcast. But tonight, 7 o'clock. Sorry that you were logging on. I don't know what you want from me. I forgot what I was going to say. Yeah, like you could say, why would you show the UFC 300? There's round card girls that are not wearing modest clothing, and this guy cursed at the end of his fight when they interviewed him. That's true. So if somebody wanted to be real hardcore about that, I can't really argue against that. But I show the fights, the guys eat, and I can't control what's going to happen. I've watched UFCs where the guys gave testimonies when they were done fighting. If the round card girl thing is too much. For me, you know where I kind of did draw the line arbitrarily? Is I was going to show the Super Bowl at our church for the men's group, and I didn't. I didn't feel... You know what I don't like? Commercials. I don't like the Super Bowl commercials. I don't... Those kind of grate my spirit, and then obviously the halftime show and all that. I don't know. It's... I think when you isolate things that happened... You know, like, I have to be careful. I wouldn't take a clip of this broadcast or a clip of Monday's broadcast and just put it on the internet. Because if you haven't been on for the whole hour and a half, it would seem like jarring. Same with Check the News. So sometimes when you take things out of their place and you don't know the context and just clip something that happened, it's like even today, not knowing that lady is a comedian doing that video and does funny videos, that totally changes everything. You know, like, if you clipped me saying yesterday that it was a mistake to ever let women vote, you know, people would be outraged. But anybody, if you were along for the whole ride, we're messing around. I feel you, Kristen. All right, let me read the rest of what Michael Brown has to say. A colleague of mine, there's no possible justification for this in the house of God. You can have some fun as men gathering together, like play sports or whatever. See, whatever leaves a lot into the realm of possibility. But you're ultimately there to meet with God and be changed by the word and the spirit, not to see some carnal performance like this, let alone by a male stripper. Again, it's harsh to keep calling him a male stripper when he doesn't do that anymore and he claims to be a Christian. That's mean, kind of. This is new compassionate, Jonathan Duggan. Let me just tell you something. You're not going to catch any meanness on this broadcast anymore. I'm going to call McGoss even for Check the News. We're going to do away with the vote rigger song. You're going to see a totally different ministry where we're kind, gentle. There's going to be a lot of flowers, a lot of pink. We're going to lose our minds if Trump is reelected and just go to the streets of D.C. screaming at the air. Let's read number 3 and 4. The proper protocol would have been for Mark Driscoll to speak to the pastor privately, urging him to immediately correct the situation with repentance and an apology, then allowing Driscoll to say what was on his heart too. If the pastor refused, then the right thing to do would be to tell the pastor that you could not participate in the conference and then issue a public statement as to why. So technically, Driscoll did not follow proper order, but no one has the right to complain about this in light of the greater offense that had taken place, namely the carnal performance. Back to me. Again, this is the what if you want to go this route in the ministry where you have, it starts to get murky when you start asking, like, is this a sin? You know, it's not wrong to do this. If you just start doing things that aren't a sin specifically and aren't wrong specifically, but rather than asking, like, is this anointed? Is this, like, so, you know, a good thing biblically? Is this a spiritual thing? Then you end up getting in trouble. You can get in trouble because it sends you down the wrong path. That's where you get, is it church at the movies? Is it wrong to show clips of movies at church and teach from it? No, not technically, but it doesn't work. It's like a bad thing for some reason. 4. Matthew 18 has nothing to do with this at all, because that's what Pastor John Lindell said. That Matthew 18, he should have spoken to me privately. The pastor or the performer did not sin against Driscoll personally. He, they, you don't want to assume pronouns, sinned against God and those attending in general. I don't know about that. Did he sin by doing what he was specifically contracted to do at the event? Again, you can't treat it like it's he was told to do something. He was told to give his testimony and ripped his shirt off and did all that. That's not what happened. He didn't sin against people attending. He did what they asked him to do. Matthew 18 applies to matters of personal offense and sin. That being said, again, the proper order being under the authority of the leaders for whom you speak while there would have been to speak to the pastor first. But I'm personally glad that Driscoll said something, even if he didn't follow perfect order. And our entire focus should be on why on earth this man was invited. May he really come to know the Lord. Again, a little judgy because he claims to be a Christian. And why the pastor allowed it, not on the protocol of Driscoll's actions. Pretty correct take. Do we have Sword Swallower International information available? Need time? Well, this would be a good time. That's all the media I sent, right? This would be a good time to make you aware of our monthly partner's gift for those that stand with us to preach the gospel around the world. Anyone that gives today, I'm going to send you this shirt that I'm very proud of. I didn't design it, but it was my idea. I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was a Moldovan sword swallower. We changed that from Moldovan male stripper because he doesn't do that anymore, and he claims to be a Christian, so I'm not gonna hang it over his head. I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was a Moldovan sword swallower. With the Moldovan flag, you don't see it that much. It's a gussied-up Romanian flag. He took the Romanian flag and put a nice coat of arms in the middle. So I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was a Moldovan sword swallower. 3 potential lawsuits coming my way, potentially pictured in the middle. But Rom, who has no legal experience whatsoever, has assured me that it falls within public use. So I'm sure the judge will take his advice very seriously in my defense. Your Honor, in my defense, I checked with our media guy, who barely finished high school in Florida, and he assured me that I could make this T-shirt. Let me see the shirt again. I went to the Stronger Men's Conference. How are your grades, Rob? C's and B's?
Yeah.
Yeah. I had a feeling. I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was we got a media team that spelled Los Angeles, L-A-S-A-N-G. I'm surprised they even put the space in between the S and the A. I went to the Stronger Men's Conference, and all I saw was a Moldovan sword swallower. I'm going to send that to you as a way of saying thank you for real, for helping us do what we do. I was going to teach on some stuff, but that video, I can kind of see how Mark Driscoll felt, because it sucks the teach out of you. Like, you don't watch that and get a fiery passion to deliver the word of God. It's kind of like, I don't really want to live anymore. I don't want to be on this planet. You know what? I've had a good run. It gives you more of that feeling. Crunch Davis, who sounds like an action figure, it would have been acceptable if he, one, gave his testimony before or after the performance. They didn't contract him to do that. He might have not been allowed to do that. Number two, didn't lick the sword. I think we all can agree. But I also don't know what's required to jam a sword down your esophagus and not die from it. So I don't know. I'm taking the advice from the broadcast. I'm not judging. Kelsey said, please don't take down the vote rigger song on CTN. I look forward to it. There was a really nice family that came to our church, our services in Georgia. Like, they were like a really classy family, and they had little kids. And the kids were like, we watch Check the News every night. And I was like shocked. I said, really? Your mom lets you watch that? And they went, well, she mutes the song that opens up, or she makes us look away, or we fast forward through it or something. So I'm glad somebody enjoys it. It's a mess. It's a mess. So we want to commemorate that mess. Here's the T-shirt. We want people to never be able to forget it. Here's the ways you can give. Any giving of any kind, this shirt's heading your way. And if you do big giving, you have my heartfelt appreciation. As we preach in Los Angeles all this week, I like that picture. Still strikes me funny even when I'm laying hands on people. Zell, we are delisted from Cash App. Must have ticked somebody off. Venmo at Revival Today, at RT Give, revivaltoday.com/PayPal. Remember, the easiest way to give, everything is on revivaltoday.com, and you click Give Now. If you want to mail a check, Revival Today PO, I love that picture. I love these new graphics, guys. Revival Today PO Box 7, Prosperity, Pennsylvania, 15329. We should come up with a second shirt. I've never seen YouTube has been holding, and it's not a freeze out. It's been holding at the exact same number for a long time. I've never seen that. Oh, no, it moved now. It's just not tracking it on there. No, there it is. It updated. Let me see the address again. Revival Today, P.O. Box 7, Prosperity, Pennsylvania, 15329. If you want to mail a check, don't forget to claim your offer at revivaltoday.com. Claim my offer. Let's run through some business. We've got our Wednesday night church service coming right up in 4.5 hours, 7 o'clock, 107 Patton Drive in Coriopolis. Coriopolis, Pennsylvania, 107 Patton Drive, Coriopolis, Pennsylvania. My wife's preaching tonight. We're organizing our leadership at Revival Today Church for all the outreach ministries, bowling team, fishing, all that stuff. So if you're a member or want to be a leader in the things I've outlined the last few Sundays, don't miss tonight's meeting in Pittsburgh. If you're anywhere near Los Angeles, anywhere in California, Arizona, Nevada, come see me tonight through Friday here where I'm at right now. I'll be preaching back there at the Sheraton Gateway, Los Angeles, right by LAX Airport. 7 o'clock. Meetings have been great. You can register. It's free to attend, and we're covering parking. RevivalToday.com/events. There's me. I forgot to give you that sport coat to take to the dry cleaner. Get that stain. There's some stain on my jacket. I only wore it one time. I don't know what it is. We should have made West Coast. You're right, Rach Romero. We should have done West Coast t-shirts. I survived two broadcasts about the Stronger Men's Conference. Make that shirt. If you want to submit ideas on Instagram or whatever, you can follow me. If you're watching me today, I'm on X. I run my account myself, at JD Shuttlesworth. Instagram, at JD Shuttlesworth. But I like X best. So if you want to write me on there, I enjoy being on there and hearing from you. All right, sword swallowing information. Oh, I did. I read Ms. Vera. It was hot in this place last night. It's like preaching in a sauna. I feel like there was somebody at the Sheraton, like, I'm not giving that guy any air conditioning. Can we discuss again about the sword tomorrow? I'm inviting my friends. We will, because, all right, while you're looking up that website and screenshotting it, what are the times that John Lindell's addressing? I'm, like, really looking forward to this. This thing won't go away. Man, I got to say, I can't think of, other than, like, major... like major scandals in Christianity where people went to jail and stuff. But in the last 40 years, I can't think. What's up, Alyssa? I can't think of a worse fallout from something that happened in a church service. Can you? I mean, this happened like Saturday and it's Wednesday and it's getting worse. It's not like you can still kind of discuss it. It's actually like taking more layers. Can you think of anything? I think the Carl Lentz thing was in and out of the news by now. Right? I think the other Hillsong stuff was in and out of the news by now. This is a long time for something to be in the news. Stuff's usually in and out of the news. Like the New York earthquake was out of the news in 24 hours. Iran and Israel's basically out of the news right now. Iran and Israel. Think of how bad a service you read when the thing that happened at your church happened at the exact same time that Iran launched a four-hour missile strike against Israel, pushing us to the brink of World War III, and that's gone away, and the church service thing is actually gaining steam in the media. That is an authentic debacle. That's why somebody said, are you going to interview Mark? I tossed the idea out because I thought this was going to be like a little thing that went away by Monday and we could like have like a laugh about it. I bet you he's not looking to like, I don't know why I'm saying bet you like I'm from Wisconsin. I bet you he's not really looking to go sit at a table with me and like have a few laughs about it, especially now that it's, you know, now it followed him to Arizona. I mean, what are the chances? Can you imagine doing that in Missouri? And they're like, well, best of luck to all you back in Missouri. I'm flying home to Scottsdale. And like, hey, by the way, that dancer that you called a Jezebel and a male stripper, his mentor is a member at your church. Kristen, that's some good writing. That's true. The red heifers are out of the news. The eclipse is out of the news. Iran and Israel's out of the news. And this is alive and well. All right. What do we have? Before I end this broadcast. All right. Interesting choice of font. It's like a tombstone theme. I mean, it is in Arizona, I'm guessing, if that guy's there. Sword swallowing, the history of the art. Where are they based? Where in Arizona? I feel like this whole thing is starting to call into question my love and frequency of visiting Arizona. Is it in Scottsdale? Sign the guest book? Can I sign the guest book live on air? I can't even imagine. That guy's seen some things. I can't even imagine how much our media team at Revival Today does not enjoy doing this. I mean, like, I can't say when they signed up to be a part of a ministry, it was like, you know, I really was not looking to break down sword swallowing. There it is. Now, it's based out of Phoenix. Right in Phoenix? Is it a P.O. box or an address? We need to do something with that logo because we can't use their exact logo, right? We need to, like, we need to play with that logo. Or, no, like, have it say different things or something. I don't know. Colette Bowers just wrote on YouTube, I feel so lost right now. You know you're not doing a good job on your as a minister when people log on to your YouTube broadcast and feel more lost. How many people got saved? No, not nobody, and then this other lady, she got more lost. That's Scott Nelson. Oh, he passed. Is that the same guy? Who's this guy's mentor? What was his name in the thing, on the statement? Oh, Dan Meyer. Okay, so it's another guy that passed away. It just says Phoenix, Arizona. Maybe they're that big, they don't even need a street address. Okay, contact us. For a list of the most commonly asked questions, media. If you are a media producer looking for a sword swallower, for documentaries, interviews, or appearances for film, TV programs, interviews, demonstrations, documentaries, music videos... Music videos. Is anyone opposed to Alex Magala making a brief cameo in a Revival Today Church worship music video? Real quick, like this real, like in the back, like quarter second. Just as a head nod to all of you. For information pertaining to the historical archives, historical research, information, corrections, updates, or donations of photos, swords, or props, please contact research@swordswallow.com. I mean, I'll be honest with you. If I had to bet all my life's money on whether there was an email address, research@swordswallow.com. Like, can you imagine going to make that email address and they tell you it's taken? And it's like, what? How could that be? research@swordswallow.com is taken? Like, yeah. What else we got? Who's this? That's Dan Meyer in the most Arizona outfit ever. I'll be honest with you. If I had that jacket, I'd wear it every day. I'd wear it to sleep. The only time it would go off is when I was going in the shower or the pool. So there he is, Dan Meyer. There's some pics. It's an eclectic group. Thoughts and prayers to the Scott Nelson's family. There's some background. I'm not even going to try that one. 2000 BC, Greeks and Romans, Germans, Chinese, Japanese, dirty knees. It does have a long, rich history. Why are people logging off? Why are the numbers dropping? You're not interested in reading this? Okay, now let's close out. Let's get the... I'll pray for everybody before we close out somehow, and then... I might need a little Brit Gusmus, if you can find it, just to kind of like cleanse the palate and transition it to a prayer. But first, I need to know when John Lindell's making the address. Can I get some help from the comments as the media team searches? See who gets it first. When and where can I watch Mark Driscoll's response? When and where can I watch John Lindell's response? He He posted on, so he's probably going to do it on X. At 3 o'clock, whose time? All right, we're going to pop up Mark Driscoll's response and then find John Lindell's, and then I'll feel whole. I'll feel like I can move along with my day because we'll have, like, direction. I'll have vision for today and tomorrow. They're putting it up, Timothy. I don't disagree with that, Crunch Davis. Where do you live, Crunch Davis? I'd love to meet you sometime at a meeting. Anybody that has that as their name. Crunch Davis. You sound like a cereal box superhero. Like that would be for kids, like Crunch Davis. I was at a, look at that, 22,500 views already. I was at a men's conference last week, and well, something came up. Still would like to share my Elijah talk. Tune in at 3 p.m. to hear it. He must mean, if he didn't list a time, then he means his time. What's Arizona? Is Arizona West Coast time right now, or is it mountain time? Because they're the only state that doesn't change. It's West time. Okay, so I got to wait 3 hours and 9 minutes. What do we have from James River? John Lindell. He tweeted another one after that, Pastor Jesus, Timothy Dearman, who has never been wrong that I've known. Evil doesn't stop itself. Good men have to stand up and get in the way. I mean, that could just be like an intern putting that from one of his books or something. Was that the one you mean? Is that it, Timothy? I think that one, the bottom one was written by him, and I think the top one was written by an intern because they're like far apart. Yeah, I don't think you'd take 2 hours and then do that in relation to the other thing. Anything from John Lindell? Somebody said he was going to say something, right? What about you guys in the comments? You know anything? When's John Lindell's comment? I you know what would be cool? It would be cool if we could do a, if there was a way to bet, like they do on Polymarket on politics. Like you had to bet, there's a bet right now on Polymarket, will Israel attack Iran before Friday? But I would love to see, don't worry about it. RTC will be protected from deception. If you, okay, let me ask you this before we head off air. If we were gonna bet, will this be resolved by Friday night? Would you bet that it will be resolved by Friday night or that it'll still be going strong into the weekend? No, you know what? It won't be because they're going to have to say something on Sunday. At least James River is going to have to say something on Sunday. It'll, you know, it's not going to be over. It might be over by Monday, but Sunday, they haven't had a Sunday service yet. And let me tell you, that's not going to be a fun one in Missouri. Bold prediction, Ninja. All right, let's pray. Nobody can find anything on John Lindell or anything yet. Thank you for your giving today. I didn't do anything out of the Bible today, but the day is young. I will be on tonight. I've preached for 2 hours last night. I've been preaching every day at least once, usually twice. Today, just having a little hangout sesh. Can we place bets on attendance numbers at James River? It'll be up. I mean, there's no chance anybody misses that service this Sunday. It's afterwards. That's the question. Wow, Sherry. I'd love to hear that story in person. Thanks for doing research for me. I want to say I've been extremely careful in all seriousness not to, like, mess with Pastor John Liddell or Pastor Mark Driscoll or James River Church. So I know I've made jokes, but I'm not joking them. They're good, you know, they're pastors that are like, you know, James River is one of the biggest churches in the country. So I'm not mocking them. I feel bad any of them have to go through this, regardless of whose fault it is. Britt Gusmus?
Young People's Devotional Day 10. The title is Building Trust. It is crucial for y'all to build trust with somebody who will honor you, honor your vulnerabilities, honor your mountains and valleys, honor your communication, and seek to understand who you are. Whether it's a friend, if it's a friend who's your age, it is gold. If it's an administrator, a teacher, a coach, find those who honor you today. Rejoice in this day. Be glad in it because he made it.
Now, thank you, Britt. I'm going to completely ruin what he was supposed to add to the program because that was supposed to transition into prayer. But as I was reading the comments, somebody said John Liddell could have stopped this by addressing what went on and apologizing. At the same time, here's another scenario. Because that took place in the morning, if Mark Driscoll hadn't done what he did, I think it's almost 100% that there would have been no fallout from it. I think when Mark Driscoll did what he did and then got rebuked and stormed and left the stage and then people started to boo, I think that's what got it. That's what made it like, what's going on here? Then people looked back to what took place in the morning, then found out he's a former male stripper and all that. So I could see how John Liddell might be like seething about Mark Driscoll, because I don't think if he did what he did on stage, I don't think it needed corrected or rebuked. See, if you think, which I was under this guy's on Monday, and again, I know it sounds like I'm taking sides with this. I would not have that. But I'm saying, looking at it from his perspective, I thought that all took place in the same service, but it didn't. And they were with each other all afternoon in between when it happened in the night, and he didn't mention it to him. That's why he was said, you could have mentioned that to me at some point in the day. But if he didn't do that on stage, you saw the reaction of the crowd. Everybody was clapping and fine with it. So it's not like people were storming out and booing, and then it would have turned into something. I don't think if Mark Driscoll did what he did, you know, that's an alternative perspective. If Mark Driscoll got up and just preached, I don't think any of this happened. What a mess. One of the things I said Monday, that verse in the scripture, know those who labor among you. Don't, you know, when you have in people just to draw a crowd and they have no attachment to you and you don't know them, like, I know Dag Haywood Mills isn't going to do anything when he comes in to mess my church up. I know Paul Nietzsche's not. I know Rodney Howard Brown's not. I know Jesse Duplantis. I mean, think how these guys are. They don't act like that. Jesse Duplantis asked me the first time I had him in, think of this, I'm like 41. How long would you like me to preach? Would you like me to pray for people? And if whatever I said, he would just do whatever I said, you know, which is like, he doesn't, I told him, I said, do whatever you want. I said, I'm not going to tell you how to, I'm happy to have you minister. But that, what I'm saying is that's the posture those guys have. Think of even when Dag Haywood Mills called me when he went back to Ghana. Would you mind if I, would you receive it if I gave you a word from the Lord? Not like, you know, who wouldn't receive a word from the Lord for him? But those guys are humble. They're not looking to do any damage to a church. When you have in somebody that's from the Reformed camp and you're in the Assemblies of God and they don't care, you know, they already don't really agree with you. Reformed people basically behind closed doors thinks somebody that's in Pastor John Lindell's boat or my boat are like not even real Christians. They think of us like we think of Mormons. So he didn't care. You could tell he didn't care to blow the whole event up. You wouldn't do that. That's interesting, Austin. Pastor John has been friends with Pastor Mark for years. When the Mars Hill stuff went down, James River was the only church that would have Pastor Mark in to preach. So he's been to preach there. But that is an odd thing to do to somebody. See, I thought it all happened in the service, the same service, and I could see myself getting upset. If it happened in the morning and you were with the pastor all day and then did that at night, that really puts a whole different perspective on it. I'll see you tonight at 7 o'clock. Sheraton Gateway, Los Angeles International Airport. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you for every viewer today. I pray that as we head into the Passover season, that there would be, just like during Passover, a great miracle, a great release to every believer. Something that's being held up, that you would force the hand of the enemy to cough up what belongs to the children of God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Ahoy. Ahoy, Heather. Thanks for the pirate greeting. I bet you wherever Mark Driscoll broadcasts is going to have a ton of viewers. People love gossip. And I know this isn't really the content anybody is with this ministry for, but I've been preaching twice a day pretty much since the start of the year. This is my first time I'm not preaching in the morning, so to just have a little morning to relax together, and get you a little laugh, it's not the worst thing in the world. I'll go back to teaching and preaching shortly. And by shortly, I mean at 7 p.m., Why defend a pagan ritual? I'm not really. I'm just commenting on different perspectives you could take. I have no interest in sword swallowing. Hello, Daniel in Montreal. You know what? I have failed the public by not making a Squirrel Talk John post in a ChatGPT-generated picture having to do with Moldovan sword swallowing. So you can look for that this afternoon. Man, I wish that broadcast was coming on now. I like really want to see it. Okay, let's bet on this together. Not actually with money. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs up for better, thumbs up for worse. Is Mark Driscoll going to go on and make things better or worse? See, because now he was a neutral observer before. he could do it from that perspective, like John Lindell and this guy are bad. Now that guy goes to his church. That's gonna put an interesting spin on it. I would lean towards worse because he likes fighting, kind of. But now, if he does this again, you know, after all this happened and you've had days to think about it, he's no friend to John Lindell if he makes things worse. That would be really, you know, after they, like, patch things up on the stage and all that. Thanks, Sandra. Oh, Timothy said Pastor Mark's doubling down today. Watch. Well, that's a bold prediction. I don't know that you're wrong about that. That would be bad. That would be really bad if he does that. That would, like, I mean, you not only are not Pastor John Lindell's friend if you do that, you hate him. You're like his enemy. Somebody on YouTube said the Lord wishes that not one soul should perish. His ways are higher than our ways. Is that ChatGPT? Oh, Carly said, how do I get that shirt? Here's the shirt in question. And you get it by sowing any seed into our ministry today. So, you know, TBN would give like a night late with the TBN logo. Jim Baker gives like a food to last through the tribulation. We give this T-shirt. To just remember, think of it. It'll be hanging up in your closet or folded in a drawer. And you'll look at it and go, what the heck is this? Oh, yeah. So it's kind of like, and you'll immediately smile. You're not buying a shirt. You're buying a lifelong antidepressant. Gina said that Pastor Mark just, and here's the ways to give. Everything's on revivaltoday.com, and you click give now. You can mail it. Don't forget to go online and hit claim my offer to ensure that we have your name and address to mail you the shirt. Mike on the app said it's going to be hard not to make it worse without him backing down on what he said because there's a lot of new information that's come out, so maybe better. Yeah, it's going to be tough not to make it worse because now that that guy's released a statement, you know, he said he just wants to do his message on Ahab that he never got to do, but you can't just pop on there and, you know, you're going to have to say something, I think. Deborah said, maybe Pastor Mark Driscoll didn't expect the sword swelling to look that way. I'm sure most didn't expect it either. You're right. But that's the new information to me that makes it different is that that happened in the morning and he didn't preach until the night and he was with the pastor all day. And I know that from people that were there. Someone said, I'd pay to see you explain this situation to your father. You want to know how I know this thing's out of hand? When I finished the first day's broadcast, my dad didn't watch it or know that I did it. And he called me, and he doesn't call me like all that much, and said, did you see what happened at the men's conference at James River? Another pastor in Maine sent me the clip. So it's like out of control. I would like to watch that with my mom. Somebody said, let's call Mama Judy. My mom has my sense of humor. We would have a great time. Yes. I hope you're having a great time in Italy, Pastor Jabin. I'm so happy for you.
Let me know, Sherry.
That's interesting. Good point, Katie. Your read is correct, Smirk 27. See you tonight, Los Angeles. Going back
to Cali, Cali. Hello, this is Evangelist Jonathan Shuttlesworth, and if you're on the West Coast, I want to invite you to something that I believe will change your life. April 14th through the 19th, Revival Los Angeles. Sheraton Gateway Los Angeles, 6101 West Century Boulevard in the great city of Los Angeles, California. Sunday through Friday, every night at 7 p.m. Pacific Time. Go to revivaltoday.com and register on our events page. It's free to attend, but you have to register. I'm going to be there, and I'm believing God not only to do great things in your life, but to do something that week that turns the tide in the entire West Coast of America. God's not finished with America, God's not finished with California, and God's not finished with you. April 14th through the 19th, I will see you at the Sheraton Gateway Hotel in Los Angeles, California for Revival Los Angeles.